Why is Tanzania's music industry successful than Kenya's? The main reason why Tanzania's music industry is more successful is because they have an abundance of music talent, or rather they have a lot of people who know what music is, how it should be sang, its dynamics, etc. It's a hard truth that Kenyans don't know music. We know how to choose good music from bad one, but we don't know what makes that music good, and this is propagated to the musicians. They will come up with some catchy crazy lyrics and rap it along some beats. Actually, Kenyans don't sing, we rap along some beats. There have been many concerns, theories, speculations, explanations of why Kenyan music is so down. Some have pointed to corruption, which is affecting all sectors of the economy. Others have pointed to low support. Musicians themselves have cried at DJs, radio and television stations not giving Kenyan music airplay. In fact, there was a time when the media now decided to be playing Kenyan music, but it was just impossible. It was hard to play the Kenyan mediocre songs, and a channel just looked as mediocre as the songs were. People could just not stand those music. The real reason is that we don't know music, its dynamics. The few Kenyan musicians who have done something which almost resembles music are maybe the artists Vivian, Sauti Sol, Bahati, Willie Paul and Size 8. Nyboy tries, but still his music doesn't come to standards of what a good music should be like. Nyboy and Christoph can be high-fly top musicians, but due to the Kenyan culture deeply ingrained in them, they occasionally rap or force words, crazy lyrics in the beats which are typical of Kenyan songs. Actually, Kenya music is mainly rap or hip-hop in nature, and for the other few who sing don't know the music dynamics. Rapping is good, but actually it's not music. It's something which should just be left for stage competition purposes only, but don't expect to rap along a beat and someone basking or resting in her house or traveling will listen to that shit in her radio. It's high time Kenyan musicians know what music is, the purpose of music, and stop blaming the media and DJs for their failure. The media won't risk losing their valuable viewers by airing mediocre songs, and DJs won't want to produce mediocre mixes by mixing songs with no flaws. One thing I realized of Kenyan musicians, unlike Tanzanian musicians, is that they become musicians because they just want to be celebrities and live that life associated with it. Always guarded and surrounded by bouncers, high social media followers, that respect, etc. In fact, most even train earlier on how they will be talking, flossing and bouncing once they become this celebrity everyone is talking about. They don't become musicians because they can sing or have a passion of it. They don't even have a music history. Almost all top musicians have a story upon which they discovered their talent. In any industry, the success depends on investment. Tanzanian artists have invested a lot in the industry compared to Kenyans. Audios are with the quality, instrumentals and videos are of the best quality. 2. The other reason is the market. Almost or nearby 98% of Tanzania artists uses Swahili language as the medium of entertainment. And Swahili language is the most spoken language in Tanzania, so through the demand of music fans, the music penetrates to the public. Unlike Kenyans, where our tribalists Luos could not support Kuyu musicians, maybe good artist, but the market doesn't require tribal music. 3. The role of the media. Most media in Tanzania supports domestic music compared to Kenya, where most Kenyans prefer international music. 4. Engagement of the government to support youth. In Tanzania, government has engaged itself in promoting music at the same time supporting culture. There is a board in Tanzania known as BASATA, Baraza la Sanaa Tanzania, which all artists are registered to be offered support. 5. The ideology of music as an entrepreneurial activity. In Tanzania, music is a legal activity which can be engaged by youth and any other person to entertain, to teach, warn or inform something which the society should be informed. In Kenya, artists are viewed as bad-mannered, or with nothing else to do. The above-mentioned points are my opinions and views as why Tanzania music industry is more successful.